In this segment, we'll take an example of how we can find eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a square matrix. So let's suppose somebody says find eigenvalues and eigenvectors for this matrix. -0.5, -0.5, -0.5, -0.5, -0.5, and 0 and 0. So in order to find the eigenvalues of this particular matrix, what we're going to do is we're going to find the determinant of this matrix, where we take the A matrix, and from that we subtract lambda times the INT matrix, and we'll put that determinant equal to 0. So what that means is that what I'm going to get is determinant of this matrix. So it'll be the A matrix, but the only thing which will be different will be that I'll have a minus lambda in each of the diagonals added to it. So I've got 1.5 minus lambda, 0, 1, minus 0.5, 0.5 minus lambda, minus 0.5, and then minus 0.5, 0, and minus lambda. And the determinant of this has to be shown to be equal to 0. Now, I can find the determinant of this particular matrix right here by using several methods, such as using the forward elimination steps or Gaussian elimination. I can use the cofactor method, and that's what I'm going to use here. So if I'm going to use the cofactor method, and let me, for example, take this as my row, which I will use for expansion, for the cofactor method. So what that means is I'll take the first row, first column, so I get 1.5 minus lambda, and since it's first row, first column, it's 1 plus 1 for the first row, first column, that's 2, so it's even, so it'll be positive in the front there, and then it'll be the determinant of the matrix which is left over once I get rid of the first row and the first column. Because it's in first row, first column, so I get rid of the first column and the first row. So I'm left with this 2x2 matrix right here. And the determinant of 2x2 matrix, this one here, would be simply multiplying this by this and subtracting what I get from multiplying this by this. So that'll be 0.5 minus lambda times minus lambda minus 0 times minus 0.5. So that takes care of that. And then I'll have the 0. So I'll get 0 from there. So I don't need to show that. And from here, this is the first row, third column. So first row, 1. Third column, 3. 1 plus 3 is 4. It's even. So I'll have plus here. Plus whatever this quantity here, which is 1. And then the determinant of whatever is left over, if I take my first row and third column out, that'll be just this 2x2 matrix. And determinant of this 2x2 matrix right here will be simply this multiplied by this minus this multiplied by this. So that'll be minus 0.5 times 0 minus 0.5 minus lambda times minus 0.5. And that'll be equal to 0. So if I do the expansion of all this, this is what I'm going to get. I'm going to get minus lambda cube plus 2 lambda square minus 1.25 lambda plus 0.25 equal to 0. That's what I'm going to get as the cube equation. You can very well see there's a lambda here and lambda here and lambda here. So I expect that I will get a cubic polynomial for the determinant, and that I'm putting equal to 0. Okay, so we have this cubic polynomial equation, 2 lambda squared minus 1.25 lambda plus 0.25 equal to 0. And you can very well see that lambda equal to 1 is a root here, because if I put 1 here, I get minus 1 cubed plus 2 times 1 squared minus 1.25 times 1 plus 0.25. And that gives me 0 equal to 0. So it looks like that, just by observation, I'm able to say that. So what that means is that lambda minus 1 is a factor of minus lambda cube plus 2 lambda squared minus 1.25 lambda plus 0.25. And what you can do is, if lambda minus 1 is a factor of this, you can always do long division like this. And let's go ahead and do it. We get minus lambda square here. So that's minus lambda cube plus lambda square. That's minus here, so I get lambda square plus here, so that cancels. Get lambda square minus 1.25 lambda plus 0.25. And then this will go by multiplying by lambda plus lambda. So I get lambda square minus lambda here. And then I subtract, I get this cancels. I get minus 0.25 lambda plus 0.25. And then I say minus 0.25, I'll get minus 0.25 lambda here, plus 0.25 here, and that leaves me no remainder. So that is the quotient when I divide this particular cubic polynomial by lambda minus 1 as the factor. So what that basically tells me is that my lambda cube minus lambda cube plus 2 lambda squared minus 1.25 lambda plus 0.25 is equal to lambda minus 1 times minus lambda squared plus lambda minus 0.25. And this one here will give you lambda minus 1, and I can write this as minus lambda plus 0.5 times lambda minus 0.5. So if I do that, I will get this second polynomial. You can always find out the roots of this. You can always find the zeros of the second order polynomial by using quadratic equation, and that's what you will get as the roots, minus 0.5 and minus 0.5. Sorry, 0.5 and 0.5. That's what you will get as the roots, and that's how you'll be able to do it. So here, by putting this equal to 0, you get lambda equal to 1 as one of the zeros, and you get 0.5 as another 0 and 0.5 as another 0 of this polynomial. Or if you put it equal to 0, you get 3 roots of the cube equation, and that's what you're getting here. And what you're finding out here is that you get 3 eigenvalues, 1, 0.5 and 0.5, but these 2 eigenvalues are not distinct, they are the same. And we have to figure out how we can find the eigenvectors corresponding to the time when we have when we don't have distinct eigenvalues. So let's look at how we can find the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equal to 0.5, which is a repeated eigenvalue. So in this case, what I'm going to find out is that I have a minus lambda I times x equal to 0. So I won't need to find x corresponding to lambda equal to 0.5. So in that, I have a minus lambda I is as follows: 1.5 minus lambda 0, 1 minus 0.5, 0.5 minus lambda minus 0.5 minus 0.5, 0 minus lambda times the eigenvector, let's suppose, x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, 0, 0. So when I'm going to put lambda equal to 0.5, what do I get from here, so far as the a minus lambda I is concerned, will be, I'll get 1 from here, 0, 1, and then I'll get minus 0.5, and I'll get 0 here, and minus 0.5 here, and get minus 0.5 here, 0 here, and minus 0.5 here, times x1, x2, x3, equal to 0, 0, 0. And what you're finding out here is that it looks like that, hey, this equation here looks the same as this, this first equation here looks the same as the second equation here, because all it is that the first row is getting multiplied by minus 0.5, and same thing is with the third row. Third row is same as the second row. So you basically will have only one equation, one linearly independent row in this whole matrix right here. because this is dependent on this, and this is same as this, so that's also dependent on this, so there's only one independent row here. And what is the solution? So if I choose x1 equal to minus a, I can choose x3 equal to a. So a can be any arbitrary real number, because if I choose a and minus a, I'll get 0. If I choose a and minus a, I'll get 0 again. If I choose a and minus a for x1 and x3, I will get I'll get 0, irrespective of what I choose for x2, because there is 0, 0, 0 here, no matter what I choose for x2. So I can choose x2 to be some other real number b. What that basically tells you is that minus a, b, and a is the eigenspace corresponding to lambda equal to 0.5. So what about the eigenvectors? So if we want to find the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equal to 0.5, what I'll have to do is I'll have to see what this means. So you got minus a, b, and a, and I can write this as a times minus 1, 0, 1, plus b times 0, 1, 0. So I can write a times minus 1, 0, 1, plus b times 0, 1, 0, and if I add these two, if I add this linear combination of vectors, this is the vector which I'll get. And if you look at it from that perspective, then these are the two eigenvectors. So those are my two eigenvectors, which are corresponding to lambda equal to 0.5. And similarly, in lambda equal to 1, so similarly, there is another eigenvalue, lambda equal to 1. Similarly, you can find that the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 1 would be as follows, would be 1, minus 0.5, and minus 0.5. That's what you're going to get as the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 1 if you follow the same procedure. So what you're finding out here is that this is your third eigenvector. So this is the third eigenvector. You have a 3 by 3 matrix. It had three eigenvalues, 1, 0.5, and 0.5. Two of the eigenvalues were not distinct. So we have to find an eigenspace first, and then corresponding to the eigenspace, we'll have two eigenvectors, and those are two eigenvectors, and this is your third eigenvector corresponding to the third eigenvalue, which is 1. So those are the three eigenvectors which we have, this one, and this one, corresponding to the three eigenvalues. And that's the end of this segment.